yes, welcome again to you all also. How many in this group do actually consider themselves gourmet cooks? Are there any gourmet cooks in here? Oh, God, 4 or 5 of you. If you love opening a new recipe book and looking at that picture and trying to create it and just enjoy food, this kind of food, whole plant foods, you will be able to do. And there are a lot of recipe books out there that will help you if you are a gourmet cook. Some of us are just kind of in between. We do a recipe once in a while, but most of the time when we go out to the kitchen, we... Yes, look in the refrigerator. Open a can, check the freezer. I hope there's something left over that you can warm up quickly. But once in a while, we like to try some new recipes too. And then there are those of you who... Kitchen? What's that? You avoid it as much as possible. And the recipes today, we're going to start down on that level. This is for those of you that really don't love to cook a lot, but, you know, you can open a can, and so I think you're going to enjoy some of these recipes.
Sally, you know, I love to cook, but so often I'm hungry, and I have to throw something together, so I always keep certain items in my cupboard or in my freezer or refrigerator so that I can put together a quick recipe, and that's what we'll show you today.
And in your recipe section, not in your cookbook, if you turn over a couple of pages past the lecture from yesterday, you will find a handout that says, I think quick and easy meals. These recipes are all from that section. Did you find it? Just past the lecture. There are 2 pages of lecture notes, and then the next section is quick and easy. Did you find it? Quick and easy one-plate meals. Thank you. Easy one-plate meals. They also are fast. And at the end of those 3 pages of recipes, you will also find a shopping list that will pretty much, if I was careful, like I tried to be, have the ingredients needed for any of those quick and easy meals that we're going to show. Can you find the one that says stir-fry vegetables? I'm going to begin with it. Now, if you love to cut and wash your vegetables and chop and lovingly prepare them just the right shape and size, more power to you. That's just lovely. But if you do not care to wash and chop, just buy a bag of frozen vegetables from the freezer, and if you have a few fresh ones you want to add to it, you may. But there are every brand there that has a nice stir fry variety, and this is one that I use from time to time. It's just called Hodgepodge, Harvest Hodgepodge. So I'm going to open this, and maybe I'll let you open it, Robin. And while she does that, I'm going to put some seasoning in the skillet. I have a little fresh ginger root here that we're going to use. So I'm just grating a little fresh ginger root for that.
You know the secret to keep your ginger root in your freezer in a Ziploc bag, and it breaks so easy and nice. And it's just going to take the peeling off what you need and grate it and pop that in, like I said. And if you don't have a cold, you can
I'm not going to saute it in oil. I'll just put a little water in that pan to steam it. And I also want to put a little garlic in for flavor. The garlic is in there. And I'm going to put a little soy sauce in there. This is our Bragg liquid amino soy sauce. You can always add a little more of that later if you want it. I'm going ahead and put the vegetables in, Robin. The broccoli in it.
Black chestnuts, red peppers, carrots, snap peas.
The frozen mixtures don't take very long to cook. So just get them nice and hot and steamy, and they'll be ready. It's easy to overcook the frozen ones if they're too soft and mint. And Asian food isn't quite as tasty if it's not a little bit tender, crisp, we call it.
Does that work? Did you stop before you think?
Because it does tend to stay cooking a little bit when you take it off the stick. So, yes, just before you think it's ready. If you have a rice cooker, as Henry mentioned yesterday, that's great. You could cook your rice, takes about 50 minutes. If you don't have 15 minutes, you can have 10. And I suggest a box of a quick brown rice. This is the Success brand that I have used now for several years since my daughter introduced it to me. You have several little bags in it like this. You don't have to measure your rice at all. You just get a can of water, cold water, drop the rice bag in it, put it on the stove. When it starts to boil, time it 10 minutes, your rice is ready. So we've already done it for the step for you. And it turns out very nice. Maybe not quite as nice as a rice cooker. If you're Asian, it might not suit you perfectly, but I think it's pretty good. And then
there's quick brown rice that you can get with just five to a bag. Also, you can eat it all. And it takes 10 minutes to cook.
This is probably enough for two people. Put the rice on there, and let's just flip those vegetables over. If you want to put a little other kinds of seasoning on it, it's okay, but you don't need to. I just think that a little soy sauce is fine.
One thing that I like to use, and you're going to say, let's not use before, but I keep a little bottle of and just like 2 to 3 drops. This gives it a really nice flavor. Voila!
Let's just put a couple drops on
it. It's just flavor. So, that's what you're going to talk about. This time of year, we're all the beautiful vegetables that are there. They all are either in our garden or from neighbor's garden. Just a great, healthy, quick thing you can put together. And you can be so creative and give it to the other folks. So just announce and talk about the nuts.
If you don't have nuts, you just have toasted nuts with your vegetables. Another option might be a few cubes of tofu. Throw in with this so you have a little protein. I think that's just about ready.
See how that didn't take very long to cook.
You can put your rice in your fry pan at that point and just stir it all together if you want to. We usually put the vegetables on top, but you have to stir the other side. On top of the rice. If you want to add a little bit of gravy or sauce to it, just mix your cornstarch with a little water and a little bit of soy sauce, and you can have a little thickening gravy as a little time to your dish when you're getting ready to serve it, but doesn't add necessarily much flavor. And for protein, a few toasted almonds.
Or you can toast cashews.
Toasted
cashews. Wash up. In a colander and wash them out with hot water and then toast them. They're delicious in a stir fry. See, that's a real quick and easy healthy meal right there. Thank you.
I might mention, if you don't want to use rice, noodles could be a very good option for your stir-fry vegetables. Sometimes we do stir-fry with noodles, too.
Polenta with ratatouille. Ratatouille is a French dish with typically a plant, some kind of summer squash, green and red peppers, onions, garlic. Those are the basic things that go into ratatouille, tomato. This is a little, maybe Americanized version. We've already sautéed the onion and the eggplant, a little bit soft steamed it, in water, because that takes a bit of time. It maybe took 10 minutes for me to get this to this point. And we now we will add, here it says, simmer the squash slices, the chopped, and I go ahead and add some chopped peppers. These frozen, this happens to be a combination, Trader Joe's combination of yellow, green, and red peppers that are sliced. And it's really a nice thing to keep in your freezer, especially if those of you that are, I think, one or two people. It's real convenient to have so common. To add some summer squash, so I've got some chopped zucchini, and then some yellow squash. It's actually a yellow zucchini. I'm going to let that cook for just a moment. Zucchinis don't take very long to cook, nor the peppers. One thing that I don't think is in here that should be without a doubt is garlic. We forgot to put garlic, so put on a list that you've got to put garlic in here. I don't think the French would cook anything without garlic. It's got to be in here. So we would pretend that we've got garlic in here. And how many of you made ratatouille? Yes, it's a this summer, I served it. We had sort of it was actually an Italian meal and a buffet. And I had a big bowl of ratatouille from the buffet with all the Italian food, and it went well with all the pasta and things. It was delicious. My garden was just overflowing with eggplants. So I'd do anything to. To use up my eggplants. Yes, let's talk about the polenta. How many of you, Sally, could you find a package and you can show them the polenta? Do you have a package right here?
I think I dropped it in the transition.
Oh, dear.
I got it out. I'm so sorry.
That's okay. You can buy polenta already packaged, and it's kind of like a tube. And it comes sometimes with a basil herb flavoring, sun-dried tomato polenta I've seen. It's not in the refrigerated section. I find it in our nutrition section of our supermarket, where the supermarket in Old Town in Oregon that carries a lot of nice healthy foods.
I think I've seen it near the pasta usually. And they do have one brand that they put in the deli, but it's got maybe cheese and maybe some other things that you wouldn't want in it. Plainer ones are usually red by the pasta in my workplace.
But is it like my husband insists that I keep always two or three tubes in tubes because they're sort of like sausage, you know, they've been rolled in plastic, you know, pies at the end, and they're about this long, and you can just cut them. And Henry likes to eat when I'm at home. This is what Henry makes. He'll make polenta, and he'll pull out a can of stewed tomatoes and a can of beans or something, and pour on top of his polenta. I'll make a nice hearty meal for him. Okay, I think this is fine. We'll now add, I was going to add the parsley, but I think I'll wait and just sprinkle it on too much. Oh, interesting.
Tell us what
is the most important.
During the summer months, she doesn't use bottled spaghetti sauce.
No, typically I would already have tomato in here, chopped tomato, and some basil would be great. Maybe even some oregano would be nice. But today, I wanted to show you, as it suggests in this recipe, if you purchase some of this spaghetti sauce, this one has mushrooms, but it's fat-free. So look for a spaghetti sauce in your supermarket or in the nutrition section of your supermarket that's fat-free. Because a lot of them have olive oil or oil or something added to them. But this one is not, does not have that. So we're going to add a little sauce.
This is looking good. That really is looking good, Robin.
Save the spaghetti sauce and we have pasta. See, 2 meals out of this one jar of spaghetti sauce. And the next demonstration now is going to be another way to use this polenta. You know, while we are getting ready for that, there's something I want to talk to you about. That's a stir fry. And I've missed it. But how many of you know about edamame?
Few
of you do. Edamame is green soybeans. And if you eat in a Japanese restaurant and you see people sitting around picking out these long pods out of a dish, sticking them in their mouth, and walking down and pulling on the pod, and the beans pop in your mouth after eating edamame. And I guess edamame is a Japanese word. That's how we discovered it. We saw people eating these funny things in the restaurant. We said, what is that? And we had to order some, and we were hooked. And so our grandchildren and children, and they're absolutely delicious. Just like we were saying, sticking it, you would either, I sometimes want to do like this, and pop it in my mouth, we're going to let you sample them today at lunch. But they're, pardon me? No, don't eat the whole bean. I went into a health food store in British Columbia to find some for a cooking class one time, and they said, oh, no, I don't care that those things. Those are horrible. She said, you can hardly chew them. I says, well, did you try to eat the whole pot? She said, well, yes. I said, well, you're not supposed to do that. Snap peas. okay, this isn't the same as a snap pea. Yeah, but this is a soybean. So this isn't a pea. This is a soybean. And you don't want to eat it. You can buy them already shelled that you can pop into soups or stir fry. But a good quality of protein and omega 3, do you think, fatty acids? Any physicians here, scientists could tell us. And then grandchildren, be sure that you introduce these to your children and grandchildren. And they love them. My grandchildren call them Pop Pops. I like them so much. And sometimes for an evening meal, we'll just have that and some rice with soy sauce or Japanese ramen soup. Sally's going to be demonstrating that to you today. And then boil up some of these. You only boil them for about 7 minutes. And then you can serve them still warm, or you can serve them cold. They're good anyway. A great picnic food, too. Take boil some up quick before you go off to have a picnic, and you'll really enjoy those, too. So, I'm going to be back here in just a moment to continue on with her. And oh, I'm doing this one. I'm sorry. I was waiting for you. All right. This is the Mexican polenta. Okay, Mexican polenta. Have you found that in your book? Or on the page? You brown the polenta, which we've done. Now, Sally has placed this corn on here. If it's summertime, and you can buy corn on the cob down the street, or take it out of your garden, or go to the farmer's market, then you wouldn't need the polenta for this dish. So either use the corn on the cob as a side meat, a dish, or you can use the polenta. So I'm going to place this corn on this top to the side here, and then we're going to do we need a frying pan? Maybe we didn't bring an extra frying pan. That's okay. There we are. We found it. Okay, we've already sauteed onions and garlic in here to speed up this demonstration. And now we're going to add the lime juice. How much lime juice am I supposed to have? This is a half of a tablespoon. Okay, I'm just going to really squeeze this on here. Lemons and limes are just indispensable in my kitchen. I like to keep them all the time. Lime juice is great salad dressing with a little minced avocado and lime juice and salt makes a great salad dressing. Or lemon juice. A teaspoon of chili powder. Is this the chili powder? Okay, we got chili powder and probably cumin. Yes. Yeah, this is not chili. Is it chili? We don't call it chili powder. It was chili
oil, ground chilies.
Okay. Nasty pan. I'm just going to blend the flavors of these. Okay. And then we put in the zest, the lime juice, the cumin, and the chili powder. Or the chili, as you want. Mild brown chili.
For those of you who have not discovered this product, this is Spice Hunter brand. And I've been looking for the chili flavor without the hot, because we like mild. I love it personally. And so this is the Spice Hunter brand, mild chili, New Mexico chili pepper. It's very mild.
I think it's just a tiny touch of water. Okay. Going to add some of the black beans. We're doing that for us for this one. Okay. And then some of the tomatoes.
Part of the can, I think, right? Mm-hmm. Recipe here.
It's good. It's delicious. I've never tried this recipe. Maybe I can teach this one to Henry. It can be a new Henry recipe.
You wouldn't think lime would be good with beans. I'm going to have a recipe with orange juice to flavor the beans. And this is very Mexican lime or Caribbean, maybe. I'm not sure. Mm-hmm. It seems to work.
Okay. I typically let this cook maybe another 4 minutes, and we're going to carry on here.
So, let's go ahead.
Spoon this onto the polenta. Oh, this looks so good. It smells wonderful. See these things you can do with onion and some garlic and canned beans and canned tomatoes. Just simple. We'll pretend we have a big ear here, this baby. Doesn't that look great? We still need the burner on. Okay, now if you, like I said, didn't have a, if you had corona cob and didn't have the polenta, you would just, you could do the beans and rice if you wanted, or just the beans by themselves. This bean mixture, along with the corn on the cob on the plate, and a nice green salad, and that would be a beautiful meal right there. Oh, let's sprinkle this with some of this cilantro. I know cilantro is a taste that you have to acquire, but what you do.
What you do, you put it on everything.
Okay. All right. The next thing, Sally's going to be demonstrating to you what we call a stuffed baked potato.
Can you find your baked potato recipe with cheese sauce there? Broccoli cheese sauce. Baked potato with broccoli cheese. I have a nice baked potato here, good size. If you're doing a one-dish meal, you need a good-sized potato. Maybe a couple little red ones if you're doing the small potatoes. And sometimes for diabetes patients, they do better with the red ones and the white ones rather than the long-breasted baking potatoes. Mash it up a bit, as though I were going to eat it. You can salt it a little if you wish. Add some pieces of broccoli to it. Maybe that's a little bit. Just cut that one for me, woman. I like to make them approximately bite size. Okay. think we could warm this cheese sauce up a little. I have the pan there, but let's just stir it a bit. This is the cheese sauce that we made yesterday, and it tends to get a little thick like gravy when it's cold. So I'm just going to stir that up a little. You would, of course, have a pot where you put it over your potatoes.
This is one of our favorite beans. And you know what would be good on this, too, is that bean mixture to stick.
Oh.
That would be really tasty. Or a can of chili.
Over a
baked potato.
Over a baked potato.
Mm-hmm. You can do this just like you would a haystack.
And for garnish, you like to put what red on your baked potato?
Tomatoes, olives.
Tomatoes.
I believe the green onions on the top. Oh, no, no. Green onions on most people.
A little olives, a few olives, and a nice color as well as some flavor. A little more fat. Natural, good green fat.
And in the summer, which is now, I'm overrun with cucumbers, I make good chopped cucumbers in it too.
Oh, that would be delicious. Yes, I like that very much.
That was quick and easy. Just microwave a baked potato, get it tight in your oven.
Now, let me just tell you a little bit about that cheese sauce that you had yesterday with the that we've used. It's in your fast food recipes. I think it's on the last page. Melted cheese sauce. All you need is a blender, but you do need a blender for this recipe because you have to blend the nuts or the nut butter, whichever you're using, along with the color. And we usually use pimento, but you can use red pepper. You could use roasted red peppers if you like a little hint of smoked flavor to your cheese sauce. For those of you who are gourmet cooks, it adds a nice touch. Just use the smoked, roasted red peppers to give it a smoky flavor. And throw it all in the blender. Blend it until it's super smooth. The most common mistake people make when they're first starting to cook gravy and sauces with nuts is not to blend it all together. And you have a gritty base then for your gravy. So blend it until it's smooth as cream. And it takes a couple of minutes in your blender, but don't put all the water in to start with, as your recipe says, just a small amount of water with the ingredients until it gets super smooth, then add the rest of the water. Because once you add all the water, the material does not stay down in the base around the blender blades, and it flops all over splashes all over the blender so that it won't get smooth. So blend it smooth first, down in the bottom of your blender, then add the rest of the water. And then just cook it like gravy. It'd be ready in about 5 minutes. So it's an easy way to have a cold melted cheese without a dairy cheese. Next, Robin is going to do the burrito for you next. And I understand you and Henry love burritos.
Love Mexican. Nice, sort of shaped. This is a whole grain tortilla, and I would soften it first. This is a little bit stiff, but if you warm it up in either your microwave or, the toaster, that's what you do, like at home, Chen was saying, just stick it down on your toaster, one side of the toaster, and you want to do this, and turn on your toaster, and it would make it nice and soft.
You know, sometimes I found that these big sprouted wheat tortillas that don't have any fat added to them are a little hard to work with. But if you soften it, and then if you spread everything around all over the tortilla instead of just trying to keep it all in the middle, and then roll it up like a wrap instead of making a pocket like a burrito, sometimes rolling the whole thing into a roll and then just slicing it in little slices makes it easier to work with those tortillas.
Absolutely. Sally, did you want me to use the real beans? Okay, I've got a can of organic refried black beans here. And the ingredients. ingredients is just organic black beans, water, and sea salt. Brand 365.
Anyway, these came from Whole Foods. And you may think, oh, I never shop at a Whole Foods because it's so expensive. Their store brand is not terribly expensive. When I started buying these refried beans, they were 99 cents a can. I mean, that was a special. But I found that for 99 cents a can, now they're regular, they're up to $1.29, but still reasonable for organic canned beans. And it's not easy to find black beans.
That's true.
You don't have a Whole Foods in South Bay? Sacramento is the closest, I guess, yes. Well, just use a can of black beans and mash them up to make your own. Just take a potato masher and mash your black beans up if you want black beans, or you can use pinto refried.
Sure. Okay, and we could add a little rice. And have some leftover rice from the day before the meal we had yesterday. So why not add a little rice? See, that's what I like. Whenever I make rice, I always make it extra. I really tend to only cook a full meal two or three times a week. And the rest of the time, I'm making meals from those meals, you know, because you have leftovers and you can be creative. Kind of nice combinations together. Okay, now this, if you found the burrito in your on the page, the list with the list of things to put in a burrito, you can do frozen corn kernels, rice, olives. Got a few olives here. And you learned about green ripe olives. They're absolutely delicious. Green ripe olives, you should try them. Okay, we're going to add a little avocado. Avocado is really nice for everything. Some people say, you know, those are so expensive. But remember, you're not buying expensive cheese and meat. And this is now, you know, it was oil. So you can afford the avocados. Then some tomatoes. And some green onions, some garlic, some salsa, maybe some bacon, I'll be able to taste it here in a minute, and some cilantro.
Some people might like lettuce.
Oh, yes, cabbage would be nice too. Okay. And then you just roll it up. And there you got it. And if you happen to have some of these nice baked chips, you can add some of those to the sandwich. Give it some crunch. And you got a meal.
And if you do have some of the cheese sauce on hand, you can use some of your cheese sauce on it.
That would be nice.
Okay. Yes.
Yes. But you have to reblend it.
You have to reblend it or take a whisk. It changes its texture or something, but it does. Just the other day, I did. And I just had to whiz it again in my blender. And it did quite heat it up.
I found this a little thing. You can add a little place to it if you need to. If it doesn't reblend the texture that you want it. But because it's made of cornstarch, cornstarch is going to soak well, like some other stuff.
While she continues to set up for the next demonstration, I noticed she had this in the deep kitchen. She didn't buy it for us to demonstrate, but I want to show it to you. It's baked organic tofu, and it has been seasoned. And at one time we were up at Limon for a visit, and went through the buffet at supper time, and they had this little bowl of a sandwich that they dip. And it was fantastic. And I asked, what in the world was that? And she said, all they did was buy this baked tofu and mash it. And it was really, really good.
You just slice it
in a sandwich, yes.
We use it in our cooking balls all the time for Chinese lettuce wraps. Some of you may have had lettuce wraps at a Chinese restaurant. And this is a nice tofu to add to your vegetables and your lettuce wrap. All right, let's do the Mexican pizza next. You find that one? And I'm going to add a little water to this onion and garlic that I've already cooked. Without water, of course, so just a little bit of, just a little bit of water. And then the refried beans.
So one of the things you're going to always want to have in your cupboard are canned beans. Refried and just plain. They usually have different kinds of beans. Kidney, pintos, bonzos,
bentos,
sweet potatoes, salad, different for the 99 cents a can, there's lots and stock up.
Now, put the beans in there, and I'm going to mix them up season. Again, this is the New Mexico mild chili. Regular chili powder is a blend of spices. It's like a bouquet of different ones. And there might be something in there you'd want to use, such as black pepper, which can be really irritating. For some people, if you have any kind of digestive problems, I think the doctors would probably say stay away from highly spiced foods. So this is an alternative to using regular chili powder.
What was it?
Here's a question. A spice blender is the one that I found, but I also found it, the New Mexico ground chilies in other kinds of stores and little packages. This came in a jar. I found it in a supermarket. But all the supermarkets do not carry spice blender right now. These are going to go on corn tortillas instead of which you just said it, so I just have a little corn tortilla here. Put a bit of refried beans on it. Spread it around to the edge of your tortilla. Can you see that? Edges, so you want to have a lot of dry tortilla, although it's good once it's crisped up in the oven a little bit. And then put the cheese sauce over it. Again, spread it out to the edges. This is all you were sprinkling it with melted cheese.
This cheese sauce makes a great Italian cheese. The other day we had Italian cheese. Cheese sauce, green beans, beets. What else was in the end? Anyway, it was just the most delicious meal.
Some garden vegetables.
Yes.
Salad vegetables. Then you get all your tortillas, beans, and cheese on them. Put them on a tray, like a cookie sheet. Slide it into the oven. Cook it about 10 minutes until, I think, let's say 10 minutes in your recipe. 10, 12 minutes. High heat, 450, low in the oven, so that the bottom of the tortilla gets kind of brown and crispy. Mm-hmm. And then when you take it out of the oven, add some red cabbage. You can put shredded lettuce on it, but personally, I don't like this. It's just cabbage just is nicer for a taste. So a little bit of shredded cabbage in here. And you can garnish it with some green onions or a little cilantro if you like. Get a bit of color. Some people will also maybe chop radishes on this. Okay, Mexican pizza. One more. Try to do it quickly. Last one is a soup recipe, ramen soup. Probably all seen these. They're ubiquitous around college dorms. And we do have vegetarian on the new ones. But if you look at the label on the back of the package, and I want you to be sure to see the label reader. So important when you're selecting things that are packaged in the kit. The noodles contain a white flour, they say enriched flour, another word for white flour, right? And the second ingredient is parsley, hydrogenated vegetable oil. Nothing in there that you want to eat as far as the noodles are concerned. You can save all the flavors, stuffing it up. First ingredient is salt. Second ingredient is soy sauce. Third ingredient, monosodium glutamate. You know, really, it's so easy to make your own pasta, so we're going to show you how. I have a package of vegetable broth. And you do not need to use packaged vegetable broth. You can use water and just season it a little. And I'm going to use a little broth. This is this one came from Whole Foods. And it just has carrots, celery, I think, onions. Just pretty basic vegetable broth. Maybe a little bit. You can use vegetable broth to stir fry it, but more flavor to your dishes if you wish. That's probably going to take a little bit to boil. And while that does, I'm going to prepare the I'm going to add the garlic to it. And I'm going to put a little grated ginger root from another recipe.
Okay.
That was only the stir fry. So let's grate a little ginger root in it for flavor. And I think we'll use a little bit of soy sauce. You can use a little bit of Dill's mixed chicken style seasoning if you want to. This will add additional salt. That would be all right if you would like. I'm going to put a couple drops of this sesame flavoring in. Pure sesame oil, it's called. And you just use it by the like you said, a drop or like a quarter of a teaspoon. Okay. And a little ginger root. You want to grate that for me? And I'm going to tell them about the vegetables that I like to add to mine. Snow peas are wonderful. Sugar snap peas, great. I like to add bean sprouts. And it's nice to add some kind of greens. I've got a little baby bok choy. So I'm just going to spread the bok choy leaves. And put some greens in it. Sometimes I use Chinese cabbage or Napa cabbage. We call it here in California. That's good too. And I don't use a whole lot of the stems. Some people love the stems, and that's okay. But I usually use mostly the greens. And a baby bok choy is just right for one serving. One person. If you're just cooking for one like I do, that's just about the time you're going to think about. Let's talk about the noodles. Some of you are shaking your head. A good alternative to white flour noodles is brown rice pasta. That's going to be used to do it. And it's just a lot like regular spaghetti.
Apparently, it's sensitive to gluten, so.
Another one of my favorites, if you see as sweet, is Holy Angel Hair. The company is D-Bowls. And you find this brand in natural food stores. Whole Wheat Angel Hair, very nice for almond soup. It's accessible to your grandma's spaghetti and Trader Joe's brand. However, the company that makes their brand is Tinky Up. So far,
that's a good one. Tinky Up.
This is a company out of Canada. It sounds Japanese, and it probably is, but it's a company out of Canada. And I'm going to add the greens to this. The noodles are quite done, but they'll finish picking all of the greens. And that's about it. You can add, like I say, other favorite vegetables. You're going to run down bean sprouts, are really nice in here.
Mushrooms.
Good, snoopies.
Carrots.
Yes, some people have grated carrots.
And, my daughter called the other day and she said, they tried making ramen. They tried for their supper. And then she said, mom, because that was delicious. So, we're going to have it again tonight. That was so good.
Let's get a shot inside of that pot for those of you so you can see what the.
Put something red in there, like red pepper. Well, if you had carrots, that's
something to do with
too. Any questions? Tofu, that's what I like to add to my lunch. Four cubes of tofu.
That is a nice protein. Any questions?
Any questions?
Yes. But don't let it thaw before you grate it. Grate it frozen. Don't take it out and get, oh, I got to thaw this first. Put it on my side. I'll try that. I'm going to put it on.
I've never tried eating it with a skin. Maybe some of you that are Asian would want to help. You would want the skin? No skin. They say no skin.
We usually peel it because sometimes, yeah, it's a little dirty, and otherwise we have to scrub it a little bit. It's easier to peel. Any other questions? Enchilada sauce, what? You mean canned or packaged? What kind of enchilada sauce? The canned enchilada sauce is pretty spicy for some of us, but you could certainly use this chili powder that I showed you, the mild chili powder, and make your own. And our cookbook has a nice recipe for enchilada sauce, but it uses paprika. And I would use the chili powder now that I found it instead of paprika. And why don't you tell them about the chili sauce that you were told not to put any enchilada sauce. Didn't you say you weren't supposed to use tomatoes in it?
Oh, I didn't. I was just told by my favorite chef in a Mexican restaurant that you never put tomatoes or tomato sauce in enchilada sauce. It's not authentic enchilada sauce. Enchilada sauce is made of bell pepper. Red chilies. Yes.
what is liquid aminos? Liquid aminos is soy sauce. It's really soy sauce. It's just an all-purpose seasoning from soy protein. That's actually what soy sauce is made from. This doesn't have any, it has not been fermented. And I guess that's its claim to fame for being more healthy. And then there's no wheat in it either. That's right. For those that are gluten sensitive, there is no wheat in it. Yes. Yes, you can. Yes, you can. So soy sauce is a little bit stronger. More intense flavor. So it's saltier, yes. Yes, it is saltier. So you'd use less soy sauce. Okay. We have run out of time.
Yeah, I think the doctors would say, for those of you that are really trying to get well from your diabetes, please stay away from frying anything. Olive oil is still good, even though it's healthier than some oils. Yes, it's still cooking with oil, and they would recommend that you just put a little water in your skillet and steam your vegetables, your onion, garlic, your ginger root. And I know it'll taste a little different for
you. You'll get used to it. You will. You will.
All right. If you'd like to come up and just look at stuff, Henry, do you want to?
We've enjoyed doing this for you today, and hope that you've enjoyed it.